Today, I will explain you how to calculate the coefficient of variation from the Monex outputs. The coefficient of variation represents the dispersion of a probability distribution. It is defined as the ratio of the standard deviation divided by the mean of the distribution. This ratio is usually between 0 and 1, but it is often also expressed as a percentage. If the coefficient of variation of a log normally distributed clearance is 30%, for instance, then it means that there is a 30% inter-individual variability. The coefficient of variation is a quite common value to report, in particular for log normally distributed parameters. Let's see what happens for a log normal distribution and a normal distribution. If clearance has a log normal distribution, it will be described by the following formula, where eta are the random effects which follow a normal distribution centered around zero and with standard deviation omega. If I'm looking at the distribution of the clearance CL, I can calculate the median, which is CL pop, the mean, which has the following formula here, and the standard deviation as follows. So if I want to calculate the coefficient of variation, that is the standard deviation divided by the mean, I obtain this formula here. If, on the opposite, I have a normal distribution with the following formula, then for the distribution of the clearance, the median is CL pop, the mean is also CL pop, and the standard deviation omega. In this case, it turns out that the coefficient of variation is omega divided by CL pop. Let's focus on the log normal distribution case as it is the most common. We can see in this formula that it only depends on the omega parameter, the standard deviation of the random effects, which is calculated by monolix. So if I want to calculate CV, I just have to apply this formula to each log normally distributed parameter using the omega values displayed in the monolix result tab. As a reminder, it is those values here in results pop param, standard deviation of the random effects. If I have a log normal distribution and omega is small, then this formula can be approximated by omega directly. So this means that the omega values in the Monex output are already an approximation of the coefficient of variation. In the table here, you can see the difference between the exact coefficient of variation and the approximate value for increasing omegas. And we can see that for omega values up to 0.3, there is less than a 1% difference between the approximation and the exact value. And to finish, note that when covariates are present, as in these examples for instance, and one calculates the coefficient of variation with the following formula, then the coefficient of variation represents only the unexplained inter-individual variability. That's it about the coefficient of variation. Have a nice week!